are renting an excavator, and we're gonna go take some trees down on some levees. Just doing some preparations for this upcoming season's crawfish crop. So, sit tight while we make our way to the field with it. And we'll show y'all a sneak peek of what we're doing when we get out there. Alright, so my brother's gonna operate this for me. Gotta get some trees off these levees. Now, we didn't have this stuff in production this year, but we will. This will be a total of 40 acres all the way down to the bottom. Some of that stuff you've seen us pushing. So he's just gonna snatch some of these trees up out the way. Dig them out. Put them in the piles to burn. Now, this is the biggest excavator I've ever rented, but I mean, it's not the biggest I've ever operated, but I'm gonna let him operate it. He's much better when it comes to excavation mode. For me, it's gotta be on backhoe mode. I can operate a backhoe with my eyes closed if there's not too much slack in it. He's pretty good at this. Thumb's gonna come in handy. Shouldn't be too bad. I came in here the other night when we did the ditching. It's drying up pretty good. We got a few puddles out there, but that sun will eat it up. Most all the water on this side just got in the ditches, which is what you want to see. Let him play around a little bit, and we got fuel coming to put in our diesel tank, so I'm gonna go wait for the truck so we can put some fuel. dry bladed this. I had to dump on the ends with the blade, and so it had a lot of mud and dirt with it, and he's just kind of picking through, spreading what the plow can handle, taking the rest and building the pile back up to burn. We'll have several piles in here to come back and burn. We'll burn them, and it'll be pretty much ready to come in here and plow it. And I gotta say, so far, I really think this is a good investment. I mean, I'm turning 2,000 RPMs and it's at about 540, 550 on the PTO. That's pretty good. You know, most of the other tractors gotta turn 2,200 RPM. Seems to have plenty of power. And it's, the AC is good in here. There is vents everywhere on this front. Shift's good. I am impressed. I was a little worried because it's the C model and it's the 75C, but versus the A series. But I gotta say, so far, this is impressive. Very impressive. Front end loader works really good. I was moving some dirt with it earlier. It's got three main ranges. And it's got four
gear. And this one came with two remotes. Can't wait to test out the lights. Whenever it's dark, we'll be doing some night stuff. But I'm cutting right now with a 7-foot bush hog. It ain't too thick of stuff right here. But I am impressed. Like I said, I love how you just kind of set where you want your 3-point. And then this lever right here, I got it all the way down. It's like it's detented. It's got a detent to it. You push it all the way down and lock it there, and it stays there. And you can pick it up, and you can actually come up and just pick the 3 points up and down with it. Or you, if I get in a bind, I'm ready to get it up real quick, like when I get to the end, just take it and pull it all the way back, and it stays lines backwards. And it comes straight up. So, for my first brand new tractor, I really think I'm going to enjoy this one. Finding some of these piles of wood from whenever we had the excavator in here. All the water you see is pretty much just some low puddles like that, but most of all the water, I rode my four wheel in it earlier, it's all in the ditches. I'd give it about another 4 or 5 days with this heat, and we'll be ready to put the plow in it. Hogging levees. So when I come with the terrace plow to build them back up a little bit, won't be such tall grass on them. Just got through pretty much doing all the levees. Just making a pass on each side. Just to do it, give me some more run time and with the tractor. I'm almost done, and then we're gonna head back and see if I can get in the big tractor, big plow. I'm gonna try to plow this stuff up a couple of times, fill it in, and then I'll come back and finish the plowing with this tractor.
A little bit of overkill, but he's gonna plow up his little garden at his house. I don't know if he got any video of it yet, but it's a Jeffrey's new little toy he got for his farm. That's no KIH four-wheel drive, does a job.
last bit of water leveling for the year. That's my little 2 acre piece. And he's just kind of dressing it off now. And then we'll be ready to plant some rice for the crawfish. So I put a couple of series of videos in here. I know it's a little long, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. So please hit that like button, comment, and subscribe for more. And we'll see y'all in the next one.